CADLink's Digital Factory 10 has been one of the best performing RIP softwares for DTF, and they just got better with Digital Factory 11. Digital Factory 10's handling of the white underbase has been amazing with its ability to print less white under black ink to reduce the possibility of flooding, as black is the thickest ink, and to give the transfer a better hand feel. With Digital Factory 11, they've taken that same tech and stepped it up a notch with variable white underbase. The purpose of the white underbase with DTF is to help protect the graphic colors from darker garments. DTF inks aren't completely opaque. Give the adhesive powder something to attach to and to give the transfer its stretchiness. When reproducing colors with CMYK, the darker the color, the more ink that's involved to produce that color, and thus, the less it needs the white underbase to protect it from the shirt color. But it also means a thicker feeling transfer. So, CADLink has made a major step forward in helping you make amazing DTF transfers by varying the white underbase, not just under black, but all darker colors. Let me show you. This was printed using Digital Factory 10. You'll see the white is really consistent all across the image. And with this gradient, you only get to true black at the very end. This was printed using Digital Factory 11, and you can see how different it looks. All the darker colors have reduced white under them. This is yet another reason we think that CADLink Digital Factory is the best RIP software for direct-to-film.